back with part three, I believe, hope I got the count right, of the Van Diemen's Land tutorial. So now we're gonna go through the chords. First, a disclaimer. Out of all the tutorials I've done, this one is probably gonna be the least accurate of all of them. I did spend some time trying to transcribe exactly what Edge was playing from the R&H version of this song. Because of Edge's singing on top of the tracks I was listening to, it was very difficult, and with the delay, it was very hard for me to pick up exactly what he was picking. And I was in a little bit of a rush at the time, so I just went by generally what I was hearing, and I basically came up with my own picking pattern. So, not that I get any of my tutorials 100% right, I don't. I do aim to try to get as close to what the Edge is playing as possible. But in this case, I really didn't worry about that. I just tried to play something that I was comfortable with. I think, as you can see in the cover, it sounds close. I'm not claiming it's at all correct. I have no idea exactly what strings Edge is playing. But first, and I might try to figure that out in the future, I'll spend a little more time on it. But right now, I thought I would get to the tutorial that relates to what I played in part one of the cover that I did with Lucas, who, by the way, did an unbelievably fantastic job on the vocals. So kudos to Lucas. So the chords, I've got 95 to 100% right. It's the picking of the arpeggios within the chord that I'm not claiming is what the Edge is doing. But let me show you what, I'm gonna show you what I do, and hopefully it's good enough for your liking. If not, you can always change it up. It's really easy to change it up because the chords that I'm going to show you are pretty much right on the money, so it's a matter of what order you pick the strings in. So let's now go with that disclaimer. I won't say that again. Just keep in mind, this is not going to be necessarily what Edge plays. The song starts off, and the way I started it off was with a G. I'm going to go through the chords first, okay? And most of these, I'm going to play the G, but I'm going to have, and with the C, I'm going to have, you'll notice my third and fourth fingers on the B and the E string on the third fret, okay? So let's zoom in here just a little bit, okay? So you can see right there, all right. So we have the song, starts off, I believe, on the G. And I started it off, I'm not gonna go through the picking here, but I started it off with something like this. So, this is a G chord, but it's a form of the G where the pinky is on the third fret right there, okay? And the third finger is on the B string on the third fret, okay? So you have this, this, and you have this here, and then that there. Some people play a G chord like this where they leave the B open and they just put the third finger on the third fret. But I believe, not 100%, but I believe Edge is actually putting these two fingers right there, okay? And doing it. Now, instead of going to a full G, C major, okay, you're gonna go here, third fret, second finger on the, right here, right, that's a, I guess it's a, in, I'm tuned in E flat, so that's an E flat, and there's a B here, there's a C, that's a C major, but instead of doing that C formation, what I do in this song, I believe what Edge does, is instead of moving all the way to here, these two are the same, just lift these and come down a string, see? So there's the G, lift, and then you're gonna go to right here and right here. Middle finger right there on the D string and the second, third fret, and then the first finger on the A string on the second fret. Second fret, this is third fret, sorry. So you got, and then you don't really play the E string, you just have this. So there's the G formation here. And all you have to do is lift these two, put, boom down, put them right here. Okay, that'll be your C formation in this song. And you leave these fingers down here on the E and the B string, all right? So I started the song, and then strike this C. That was here. So we have G, C, G. And this might be a G7th or sustained 7th, I forget what they call it. honestly, but I'm just going to call this a G and I'm going to call this a C, but it's not a C. Which type of C it is, I forget the exact details. So we got this. Now, we will get to the picking in a minute, but let me just, that's just trying to show you what chords I'm playing. Note that there's not much going on up here in the left hand. It's all in the right hand, and that we will cover later, but you can just see, watch and learn what chords I'm using and the order of the chords. That's what's important right now. So the beginning of the song, I went like this. That was my little intro. And then we're gonna go to E minor. And I actually play these notes. Go to E minor. I play it like this. It's just second fret, A and D string. And then we go back to that C. And this C is a little different. I go from this. I use the C major this time, but I take the pinky and I put it down on that G, which is now a G flat in E since I'm tuned half step down. So remember, before we did this as a C, now I'm doing this, but I'm putting this down. That's just the way I like to go from this E minor to this C. You can go this E minor and go to this, like this formation. But I don't think you're gonna need, I think you're gonna want the B open there or you're not gonna use it. So again, we're gonna go G, C, G, E minor, and then C with the pinky down here on the third fret. And then we're going to go to a D. So we've got G, C, G, E minor, C, D, B minor, B flat minor. Everything is a half step down, so this is actually B flat minor. Now, that's a bar chord, so you bar that second fret, and then put this second finger, this middle finger here on the third fret, okay? And then these two, the pinky and the ring finger are gonna go on the fourth fret, right here on the G and the D, right? At that, see that real right, so those two are right there, this one here is right there, and this is barred. That's a B minor when you're in normal tuning. Okay, so we go from D to B minor. All right, if you want to, what I'm going to do here, I should have turned off the delay. It makes it a little easier so you can hear what the chords sound like. Oh, sorry, G, C, E minor, C, D, and then B minor. And then we're going to go back to E minor. Okay? We already played the E minor. You can play the E minor this way too. I like to play it this way. So we were now went from the B minor back to E minor. And after the E minor, we're going to go to the C again. And then you're going to go to the G. And then you're going to go to the D. And then you're back to the G. And then do a CG to end the entire riff. All right? Very simple song. You just got to memorize what the order of the chords are. I'll do it one more time. G. C. E minor, C, D, then B minor, E minor, okay, now remember go to C, now again, then G, and then D, and then back to G. And then you end with a CG. Now I'm going to pick it without delay. Hopefully I'll get this right, and you'll see that order. And let me play it. That is the basic chord pattern for the first three verses. On the last verse, there's a very small, slight change up. You can see the cover. I'm going to play it one more time quickly, just the chords, and I'm going to take you through at the end what happens. You start again with that G, C, E minor, C, D, B minor, back to E minor. After E minor, we go to that C. Then we go to G. And then we go to D. At the end of this riff, of the verse, when you go to the D, remember before when we did the D, we went to the G and we ended. But when you get to the D on the very last riff, the D, you go back to the E minor. And you start over again. You do that ending a little bit all over again. So you go to the D. Then you kind of go backward and you do the ending quickly again by going E minor, and then C, and then G, and then the G. So let me play that. Let me play it. You can go back in the video and see the way I played it before. Now let me play it as if it's the last verse. So you notice the last verse is a little longer, and it's because we went instead of going to the G and ending, after this D, we go back to E minor again, then C. Then we go to the G. So watch that ending very carefully and make sure that on that fourth time, when you've gone toward the end and you've gone to the D, don't go to the G and do that. Make sure you go back to E minor and repeat it. And those are the basic chords to Van Diemen's Land. So that finishes up that part. Now we got to go to the hard part, which is the picking pattern. We will do that in the next tutorial. Thanks for watching.